Hi, I'm Thando. I am a 20-something year old newly corporate girly who just started a new job, plus trying to find a routine and keep my mental health in check. I work in the food industry, in laboratory sales specifically. I deal with microbiology, testing, chemistry, in essence, everything biotechnology related. And this is just my little corner on the internet showing you what I get up to in my life. So do stay, do subscribe, and leave a lovely comment. Love and light, Thando.
Sanbonani. I hope everyone is doing great and taking care. I hope you had a lovely month. And yeah, this is another one of my many YouTube videos. I hope you watch until the end and subscribe. This is a recap of the month that was August in all its glory. It was a good one. It was a good month, very, very stressful, a lot of anxiety, a lot of challenges, but I'm glad we made it to the end in one piece. I started off the beginning of the month with a young solo trip to Lesotho. It was a great trip just to, you know, go polisa umoya kancane in another country. It was lovely. Did that with the Travel Gen. It's a travel agency. Check them out on Instagram. It was a lovely way to meet other people and also travel as well. And then I did Lesotho, and I did a trip to Mpumalanga for work. I did a trip to the Free State for work. So it's just been a whole lot of working, a whole lot of pressure, anxiety. A lot has been happening at work. I've been getting a lot of projects, so I've really been under a lot of stress, but it was a great week. It was a great month nonetheless, and yeah, I'm thankful and I wouldn't trade it for anything in the world. Did you say you're on your way? Why now, when you just went to my head? Received of how you want me back. I know the procedure. Trying to come to my place, turn around, it's too far.
is running Julian. Why is music freaking 80 rands, 90 rands? Are you kidding me?
Good morning. Ekuseni. Today is Sunday, the 25th of August. Happy Sunday. It's currently about 9 o'clock, I think. Check. Yeah. 8:55. Have a lot to do today. I have so much that needs to be done, but I am so lazy, right? So I'm having breakfast. I'm having ama wheat bakes. I've got a lot to do. I have to drive to my colleague's place to go fetch some documents that I need for tomorrow morning. Msebenzini, because I need to submit those documents tomorrow in the Free State. So tomorrow I'm gonna be driving to the Free State. Tomorrow morning to Kroonstad and go drop off those documents at the municipality. But the thing is, my colleague lives, I live in the East Rand, my colleague lives in the West Rand. So I have to drive all the way to Roodepoort to go fetch the documents. And you know on social media they tell you Roodepoort is far. Roodepoort is further than everything. Everywhere else. Yeah, it's just far. But anyway, I have to go collect that around 12:30. But before 12:30, I want to go to the internet cafe and go print out a few documents that I need to attach to the other documents that I'm fetching. And yeah, it's just so crazy. And I also want to go to Dis-Chem to go fetch my Dis-Chem package that I bought yesterday. Kuning, like a lot is going on and I'm running around just doing all of this thing. And the thing is, all of this could have been avoided had I properly planned and properly managed my time, you know. So here's the thing. So the thing is, I was given a project at work where this project was given to me at the end of June and it's due tomorrow, the 26th of August. So I had a month to do this project. But the thing is, I was doing the project while I'm doing my day-to-day work, right? It's my day. The birds are so loud. I'm sorry. Apologies. So I was saying, I was doing this project while I was doing my normal day-to-day job. So because of that, I couldn't cope with all the work and all the stuff. Yeah, well, gee, just doing my normal job and doing this project at the same time. And I only realized, I think about 2 weeks ago, actually, this thing is due. I need to take this thing seriously now. I need to start focusing on it. Only then I started running around. And had I started when I was handed it, I could have been done at least a week ago. But again, now I'm just, yo, Friday was worse. Friday, I was running all over the place. Oh, like this project has so many like moving parts. Like you have to get documents from the quality department. You need to contact maybe one of the directors because they have to sign this, and then you have to go to whoever and ask them. You have to go to the lab manager and ask them if we are able to conduct certain tests, and then if we can't do those tests, find out from other labs which lab can assist you with this test. And like, it was just so much, like it was so much, so many moving parts. And you have to liaise with this one doesn't respond to you, so you have to wait on them before you can move on to this other part. And oh, yo guys, yo, this is such a long chatty segment, but I'm sorry. I like, this project has been giving me so much anxiety for the past 2 weeks that I remember it was a Wednesday, I don't know if it was last week Wednesday or the other Wednesday, but it was a Wednesday. I was driving home, stuck in traffic, and the tears just started rolling down my face. I was here driving, wiping tears, like, ooh, guys, Thursday, Yakona, or was it the next Thursday? I can't remember, but it was a Thursday. I went to bed thinking about this project, being anxious and overwhelmed about it. 4 a.m., I woke up from my sleep because of the anxiety of this project. I stayed up in bed from 4 a.m. until 6 a.m. just thinking about this project, thinking about it, being anxious about it, thinking, what if something goes wrong? What if this? What if that? You know what I mean? But Yazin, I'm just so glad that the closing date is coming. I just want to submit it and move on with my life and my day-to-day job. I could have done it better, sure. Had I had more time, I was going to, like, you know what I mean? I was going to be able to have time to double check my work and see if I didn't make any mistakes and this and that, but I didn't have time to do any of that. But yeah, it is what it is. I'll submit it as is. I did my best. I did my part. You know what I mean? But I just did what I had, what I could with the capacity that I had. I was very disorganized. And the thing is, I'm a very organized person. Like, I like my things to be like this, my ducks to be in a row. So now when things are not going well, I get overwhelmed. I am five to having a panic attack. And that's what happened this past 2 weeks. I can't explain to you how relieved I'm going to feel once I submit this document or this project. Whether I succeed at it, whether I don't, whether I made mistakes, angazi, but I did my part. A child. You know? So yeah, I'm going to take a bath now, and then I'm going to go to the internet cafe, print out documents, then I'm going to go to this game, go fetch my packaging. I also need to go to Pip Home, Mr. Price Home, or Sheet Street. I'm looking for floating shelves. Yeah, because I'm renovating my study, so I'm looking for floating shelves. What else? Yesterday, you saw a clip here. Yesterday we were at Leroy Merlin and China City, China Center, the one in Greenstone. We were buying izintofo around the house. We're renovating our house, so you know, with renovating, there's always something. Something that's needed. We need curtains, we need this, we need that. So we were doing all of that, and I bought paint for my study room. So yeah, I'm transforming my study room, and yeah, I need to do that and then go fetch the documents and Roadieport and then come back.
Thank you.
No. So I was here at Mr. Price to buy some work pens. I don't know how to do this, but they're too long. Can you see? They are too long. Those ones. I also got the was also thinking of getting these ones, but these ones are too small. Those ones are a bit small, but these ones are definitely small. So they're too long also. Like, why are Mr. Price work pants so long? Like, can you see? Anyway, I am at the fitting room here at Mr. Price, Mr. Parisi. I ran my errands, not all of them, but I went to the internet cafe, did what I needed to do, drove to Krugersdorp, got the documents, went to P&A, got an envelope to seal the documents in. So today was a productive one. So I went with my little sister, and we went to 1P and just grabbed some lunch, and we are now heading home. It's been a fruitful day. I will be able to do laundry. It's already 4 p.m. The day has gone, and that's it. Happy Sunday, guys. Take care. Dumelang. I hope you can hear me. I've got the washing machine running. I have just come back from the Free State. Came back and did a load of laundry because I couldn't do it yesterday. Today is a Monday. I'm having lunch. It looks very I bought this at Checkers. A lady outside Checkers who was grilling, she sells burgers, bratwurst roll, and then I just added avocado because I eat avocado with everything. I'm tired. I have a load of laundry running, and then Zonega Leo, and then I'm going to take a nap. Happy Monday. Today is Monday. I fetched my Dis-Chem package and I thought, let me do an unboxing. You know, I always do these things, these Dis-Chem unboxings. But it's the same thing all the time. There's nothing fancy, there's nothing different in this one compared to the last one. Okay, let's begin. Colgate. I think I got three. And mouthwash, Vaseline, body wash, Luxe. And then in Tipozokeza, I got 4 of these. I got intimate wash. The sun is lilanga liang kawad. Got pads, got shaving cream, got roll on, because yeah, and I got pure soap. This was actually recommended to me by my little sister. She says I must use pure soap on my face because I used Gentle Magic, the soap. But she says I must use pure soap because it's free, like free from color, free from odor, free from reactives. It's just the pure soap. So I don't know. I don't really have sensitive skin, so I really don't mind. My skin doesn't really mind soaps and stuff. Yeah, let's close it here. I'm actually sitting on my knees and I'm balancing the phone on my bed just for the good lighting. Oh yeah, anyway, I'm closing this off. Take care.
I hope there are days where your coffee tastes like magic. Your playlist makes you dance. A stranger makes you smile. And the night sky touches your soul. I hope you fall in love with being alive again.
Today is the 1st of September. Happy Sunday, happy September. It's my birthday month. I'd like to wish you a new month, a beautiful one. Happy spring, happy new season. May September be kinder, may it be softer. If August wasn't, hopefully September will be a better month. May it bring new blessings, just happiness all around. May it be warmer, literally, figuratively and literally, may it just be warmer. I'm just hoping and wishing you a beautiful month. Happy September. If it's your birthday this month, happy birthday, fellow 20. Guys, have a good one. Have a good one, and may the good Lord bless you always and always. Shikwembu shimekatekisa. Kulunkulu anibusise, modimo ale tlhonolofatse. Thank you.